The defender is fixed. Fixed. How good is that? Sorry, it's taken a couple of days to let you know. I did actually get it back on the Friday night. It was quite late though. Yeah, and I don't know, the luck I've been having, I just thought I was just gonna wait a couple of days just to make sure, like absolutely positively sure, that all was well and all is well. It's going very well. And as you can see, I have the Jayco back as well. It was in at Jayco Cairns all day yesterday. I mean, look, the list was long, but they got through it. A couple of things, TV, or DVD in the TV, and a couple of cabinets, doors that they know, or they acknowledge, they need to be completely replaced. But they're fixed now, they actually hold, you know, they're good, they're fine, they'll be right for now, but they know that they need to be properly replaced at some point, so I'll do that. Next major city, the TV can be sent off, and as can the cabinetry that needs to be completely replaced as well. So, Jayco, I have to say, I don't know if this caravan has redeemed itself yet. It still seems like the mother of all lemons, in my opinion. But, you know, their customer service is pretty amazing. They're, I mean, I guess they have to be, don't they, when you get something like this. And all those things go wrong. But Ben in Cairns was awesome, and all of them, the guy Peter from Melbourne who called, you know, they all, their customer service is great, so I have to take, you know, I'll give them credit for that. I'm not giving them credit for the caravan just yet. But anyway, I'm just so stoked. We've moved, I'm at this place called, Garadunga Hotel. How funny is this? My dad knew of this place because he worked on the railways back in, oh my goodness, like 1968. So I had to come here. And he knew this pub. Anyway, it's changed hands obviously many times since then. And now lovely Di's running it. And we're just going to stay here for a couple of days just because it's nice and it's miserable weather. Catch up on a bit of school. And then we're going to head up to the Atherton Tablelands. But anyway, this is. Oh, well, the Atherton Tablelands, and then I'm hanging out up there for a little minute, and then I'm going to put the rig through the ringer, and we're going to go to the tippity top. We're going to go to the York. Cape York. The York. What? Huh? I know Australia. So we're going to go to Cape York. All majority of it's corrugated road, but I've just spoken to two different people. One's across from me now, and another guy back at the Defender place on Friday night, Ben. He's just come back from there, and he said the road's pretty good for right now. And as long as I let down the tyres and I do all the things that I'm supposed to do, I've got my compressor to pull them back up if necessary. As long as I do all those things, you know, this is called an outback, so it's supposed to stand up to a bit of corrugation. I'm not going to take it through rivers and, you know, I'm not being nuts. But I need this van to be able to do the off-road stuff that, you know, they claim it can do. So it'll be a test, I guess. You know, cabinets fell off when I was on a sealed road, so we'll just see. Jayco. Jayco, see, I'm not even going to call you those other names because I'm happy right now. But be warned, I'll bust out those other co-names that I've been calling you for the last couple of weeks. Anyway, we're here. This pub's really cool and I'll just show you a little bit about it. My mind, listening to broken speech,
stacking up broken seats. It's a lonely picture. And I hear your voice as it echoes round my head. Always that same thing that you said. Get out, but you still care.